So can you tell us, what did you know about Black Manta and Aquaman? Yep. Okay. Tiffany Smith, and I'm doing the generic Warner Brothers. What did you know about Black Manta and Aquaman before you got involved in the project?
Before I got involved in the project, I didn't know anything about Black Manta, didn't know anything about Aquaman. I might have seen an Aquaman-type character on a Cartoon Network or something like that, where he was definitely being made fun of or something, you know. And then you step into it, you know, you get an audition, you get a job, and then you say, oh, well, now let me do my research and let me learn what this world is all about, you know. And that's what I did, and I said, oh, okay, now I have an opportunity to do something I think is going to be really, really fun, really, really special.
Well, I got to ask, you said you had one version of Aquaman.
Yeah.
How much of a shock was it for you when you read the script and you're like, oh, we're not doing that silly version of him. We're doing a badass version.
It's interesting because I didn't even have to read the script in order to know that. You know that a guy like Jason Momoa is going to step in, and then he's not your typical Aquaman. You know, he's going to bring himself, and he's going to bring a whole different flavor to any role that he steps into. So to have him take on the guy that used to be the butt of the jokes, it's really fun to know that, you know, oh, that's not gonna happen anymore, you know. While at the same time, Jason doesn't take himself really, really seriously, so he allows for the jokes to come in and things like that. So I knew that it was gonna be something that was really special. It had a really good balance of the seriousness and the kick ass, but also that was funny and humorous as well.
Well, without giving too much away or spoilers, can you tell everybody a little bit about what is the relationship between Aquaman and Black Manta?
Yeah, I think they're very, you know, Black Manta has something that was that's very personal to him, taken away, you know, and so from then on, it's a story of vengeance and a story of revenge and persistence. And Aquaman is on the other end of all of that drive, you know.
There's so much that goes on in this movie, so many worlds introduced, people introduced. It depends so much on James Wan balancing it all. What was it like working with him on this project?
James had the second most energy in the room because it was always Jason at the top, right? But James was so imaginative and so creative. And he had an epic imagination and idea for the movie that he wanted to make, you know. And it's really cool to step into a room with someone with an infectious, positive energy. You know, he could barely stay in his seat when he talked about the film and when he talked about the scenes and his ideas. And you know, next thing you know, I'm on the edge of my seat and I'm you know, moving and mimicking him and ready to go and make this thing happen, you know. So to see it last night, to see him last night, James, you know, smiling and having a really good time, it was really, really rewarding to see, you know, the fruits of all of our labor.
Yeah, and you guys all kind of sound like it was such a family environment. You all were really working together to pull each other up to make sure that your fight scene was as strong as the other person fighting with you.
Yeah.
What kind of training did you have to do to prepare for this?
A lot of time in the weight room. We had a big studio that was just dedicated and shaped out into a gym. And so it was like, you know, if you have any spare time, you're probably going to be in the gym lifting weights. They made it very easy for us to be right there. Food truck right outside, you know, the couch, the drum sets. We didn't have everything that we needed was inside of the gym. So first it was like, well, you get your butt in shape. And then second was like, you know, you put in your hours and you try to figure out how you can make a story that was physical and that was real and then safe at the same time, you know.
Well, and you're like, the muscle and building the strength is one thing, but fighting with the blades as was that something you'd ever worked with before?
I'd never done that, but that's the beauty of working on films like this, you know, you get to acquire new skills, you know, you get to learn how to fight, you get to learn how to throw a proper punch or do a tuck roll or, you know, flips if that's what the character calls for. I taught myself how to swim during the course of this because I thought that would be something that would come in handy.
You didn't know how to swim before doing the movie?
Nah, I didn't.
Oh my gosh.
I didn't. But you know, you sign up for something like this and you know, you want to do what you got to do to make sure that you can go anywhere that the story is going to take you, you know. And so, you know, it's really an opportunity to just learn more skills and put more things in the bag, you know.
That is so cool. I love that because I kind of, seeing the movie, I went in and I was like, there's so much about all of the characters, but the ocean and the water is a character in itself.
So yeah.
It's always kind of interesting hearing what, if your relationship to the ocean or the water has changed, and yours for sure has.
Yeah, it definitely has. My brother gives me a lot of mess for it because he's like, man, you know, you did two movies where, you know, you did Baywatch and you did Aquaman and you didn't know.
You're like, this is the one that I might get thrown in that I better know what I'm doing.
Right. I'd be real fair, it'd be a real short movie if Black Manta couldn't swim, right? Aquaman would just be like, okay, I'm just gonna stay over here.
Until he has the Atlantean technology, because maybe that would help. They'd be like, you don't know how to swim. Okay, we'll just put like motors in there.
Right. You know, he's very resourceful. He is resourceful.
It's true.
But now he can swim. And so,
I love it.
You know, that problem's alleviated.
Talk about going toe-to-toe with some of the people that you had to fight in this movie, because there's a couple different fights that you've got. What was it like stepping up with Jason the first time?
I was a little bit, was I nervous? I wasn't so nervous, but you just never know how these things are gonna go, you know? And this was my first time working on a big movie like this, you know, and I knew that I was going opposite a pro, you know, Jason's a pro in like the hand-to-hand combat and the moving and things like that. But at the end of the day, you know, you step up and you put all of your training in there and then it's just dance. It's just dance. And I know how to dance, you know what I mean? So it's just choreography. And then you go there, you try to make it look as real as possible, you know?
Putting all the work into it and hearing all the fans building up through Comic-Con and all the years you guys have been prepping for this, is there a scene in particular or a moment that you're the most excited for the fans to see?
I really want the fans to see the submarine sequence, you know, because that's where you learn more personal details about Black Manta, about who he is, about some of his aspirations. You know, we meet this character when he's on a high. You know, he's just come off of a really big win, and we meet him when everything's going right, and then something happens and that's no longer the case, and so. That's the moment that creates this character that people will relate to, no matter where Black Manta goes from here on out. It all goes back to that one moment, I believe, in the submarine where his life is changed, and then from there on, everything else that he does is, I believe, is justified.
You gotta believe that to play a good villain.
Yeah, exactly, right. Black Manta is the villain with a question mark, you know what I mean?
You said that's the one you're the most excited for fans to see, but is there a particular moment when you were filming on set that was your favorite?
My favorite moment filming on set? There was a moment that was my favorite, and maybe, you know, I'm not sure how it reads, but, you know, as far as moments go, but there's a moment where Black Manta's holding he's holding this Atlantean gun technology, and he shoots it at an island. You know, when you turn back over the camera, and then the camera zooms into your face, and that was one of those moments where I knew it's like, hey man, you're doing a superhero movie, man. You know, so just lean all the way into it and just be cool. You know, just put your feet in the ground and just be cool. Give them the smirk. Give them the over the shoulder thing, and just do the thing, you know, and that was really, really special. I'll never forget what it was like filming that moment.
God, that's so cool.
Yeah.
I have one last question for you. Sorry, okay. Cool. Awesome, thank you.
Oh, well, it's such a pleasure.
Nice to meet you.